Greetings from the set of Metro and More at Metropolitan Community College, serving more than 50,000 students with over 120 programs at our 8 locations in the daytime, evening, weekends, or online.
Hi, everybody. I'm your host, Kent Pavelka. This is Metro and More. More of what you need to know about Metropolitan Community College. Our 30-minute segment ahead is all about continuing education at MCC, and with us is the Director of Continuing Education at Metropolitan Community College, Gary Girard. Good to have you, Gary.
Thank you very much.
And welcome to the show, but I guess also a point to make is welcome to Metropolitan Community College. Recently came here from the University of South Dakota, correct?
That is correct. For the most part, I've dedicated my career to higher education, and I came to Metropolitan Community College after a 29-year career at the University of South Dakota. I was the director of programming for the graduate school and continuing ed. And so for the most part, most of my career has been dedicated to continuing education.
What else have you done? I mean, you say for the most part.
In terms of prior to continuing education, I was involved with technology development and faculty development, training faculty to utilize technology and incorporate technology into instruction and, mm-hmm. and into the learning process.
Well, people change careers and move from job to job a lot, but not often after 29 years. What was the allure of Metropolitan Community College after all that time?
Well, that's an interesting journey. I was in graduate school and I was taking courses, and I did a significant amount of research, and I focused some of my research on community education infrastructure. And in South Dakota, we do not have community college infrastructure. So we have technical schools and 6 public universities within the system. So it was very intriguing to me. And so I did some research, and then throughout that research, I kind of had a little bit of an epiphany thinking, well, you know, I think that a community college system maybe aligns more with my philosophy of providing greater access to diverse populations. The affordability piece of what a community college does was very attractive, and then also the outreach and the partnerships that community colleges are often involved in. And during my 4 to 5 months here at Metro, I've not been let down. Everything that I researched certainly has come to fruition, and so that was primarily what attracted me to this opportunity.
Yeah, we were talking before we went on the air about what community colleges are about and their advantages. What about the practicality of a community college education? We chatted about that. The applicability of it in the job market.
Absolutely. I mean, when you talk to faculty, when you talk to administrators at Metropolitan Community College, it's all about workforce development. It's all about bringing the learning experience to a real life kind of situation where folks can get jobs and have a meaningful job and a good paying job when they're done, and so when they finish their experience. And so that's what it's all about. So it's a community college is very practical when you talk about mm-hmm. it in that term.
Well, and with respect to what you're doing here and our topic, continuing education, really not so much, right? This is sort of an addition to what you've learned in the past, not necessarily designed to get you a degree or anything like that.
Right. So continuing education is kind of like an all-encompassing term that brings together community education, adult education, and even like lifelong learning. And so it brings all of that together, and continuing education here at Metro is the non-credit arm of the college. And so I like to characterize continuing education, it's programming that's offered for the public good. So we look at providing learning opportunities from birth all the way to learning through retirement. And so when you look at that continuum of learning, that can encompass youth through our College for Kids, College for Teens, workforce development kinds of learning opportunities, enrichment personal kind of opportunities, and then people who already have degrees or even advanced degrees, but they need refresher kinds of learning opportunities to stay employed or even to get to the next level. So that's what I see as continuing ed at Metro.
Just to give us kind of a feel for how big an operation the continuing ed part of Metro is, do you have a feel for how many people avail themselves to what's offered?
It's very significant. In terms of the number of participants or students that we touch within a year can range from 17 to 20,000.
Yeah.
So
that's a lot
for within the greater Omaha area. Absolutely.
And that, I don't know what the four credit numbers are, but that's pretty close, I think, isn't it?
Well, I'm not the expert on the four credit side, but I think four credit is typically about double that. I mean,
is it double? Okay.
I mean, it's pretty
significant. Well, still 17 to 20 is a lot. Do you think these are people that more often are taking something at Metro non-credit for the first time, or a combination of people coming back, or?
It's interesting. I think that we have a lot of repeaters. So that was one of the questions that I had when I first came here, is like, who is our audience and who are we serving and who continues mm-hmm. to come back? We get a lot of folks who are repeaters and who are coming back. So just to give you an example, when I first got here, I took a culinary class from our Open Kitchen series, which is hugely popular within the greater Omaha area. And there were folks in that, there were about 20 students, and I would say about half of them were coming back because they had such a positive experience and they're learning how to cook Italian and whatever that class was or other courses prior to that. And then there was a husband and wife team who came, there was a mother, daughter, and then there was another set of group. There were three sisters who all decided that they were going to, you know, come to this class together. So I think that a lot of the continuing ed, you know, outside of the workforce development, just brings people together for a learning experience, just for the like I mentioned before, for the public good and just for enrichment. And for fun.
Sure,
also.
For pleasure, yeah, actually. Well, I mean, one of our missions here in the show is to let people know that this is available. And the best place, I guess, for people to learn about it in detail initially would be the website. We can go to that and take a look, and you can kind of give us an overview of what's offered.
Yep, and so we have the website that that you can go to mcc.edu/ce, mm-hmm. and then that would be the primary place where you can access our non-credit schedule, and you know, with the registration options, you can enroll online or call our instant enrollment and enroll. That would be the primary methods, and then there's also a phone number to contact on our website where you can call to get additional information mm-hmm. Information to enroll. In addition to that, we have a catalog that we send out to the greater Omaha mm-hmm. area that lists all of the courses that we offer. And then the catalog is categorized by workforce development and enrichment and a variety of, you know, sports and games and home and garden and animals and all kinds of different kinds of topics within that catalog.
I assume you can call the number and ask for one of these
yep.
if you didn't get
if
one in the mail.
If you're not currently getting it,
yeah.
yep.
And you should be.
Yep.
You're in the Four County area.
Absolutely.
So at any given time, how many continuing education courses are underway at the college?
Well, hundreds.
Wow.
And so right now we go on the term semesters, so on the quarter system, so we have
just like four credit
mm-hmm. exactly mm-hmm. and then continuing education is all over the greater Omaha area we're in Sarpy, Elkhorn, all of the different sites, a variety of public schools, and you know, all over the greater Omaha area.
Yeah, so I was going to ask you about where are these classes? Everywhere, right?
Yeah, they are everywhere. And then we've just opened up on the second level of the Dew Space.
Yes, let's talk about that. 72nd and Dodge.
72nd and Dodge, a very busy intersection.
I mean, you can't have a better location than that.
Exactly.
So Dew Space, what is it?
Well, the Dew Space is an interesting concept that is unique to Omaha, and it's a community technology library. And so on the first level of the Dew Space provides all kinds of access to a plethora of technology. They have a 3D lab, all kinds of computer, PC, Apple kinds of computers that are very rich with technology. There's a Littles lab. There's also there's a teen lab that they have, mm-hmm. and even conference space. The Dew Space was conceptualized out of the Heritage Trust Foundation, and MCC occupies the second level of that space, 10,000 square feet of learning space. So that provides us a forum in terms of MCC. To the first level provides access. The second level provides
instruction
mm-hmm. and application. Mm-hmm. So we take that access and then provide application for real life experiences. And so we'll provide a variety of certification kinds of courses, professional certification for workforce development. Again, like I mentioned before, enrichment kind of courses, you know, like social media kind of certification, a 3D modeling certificate.
Social media certification?
Yep.
What do you?
I'm
on it enough.
Do,
I think I should be certified.
Exactly, but there's all of these social media entities like, you know, Facebook and Pinterest and
sure.
Twitter, and so we'll provide MCC experience and even community expertise to put together a learning experience, a build upon learning experience that will culminate in a certificate or a badge kind of learning opportunity that will clarify all of those different kinds of social media entities and then apply it to your business or to your small business, or maybe you have an entrepreneurial spirit
marketing,
and you want to
from the marketing angle. Yeah.
But we'll have a variety of different angles. It could be a marketing angle or maybe an entrepreneurial angle, mm-hmm. or just maybe you're a retired person and you want to better understand what Facebook is, and
sure.
you want to talk to your grandkids that are across.
Yeah.
Across
well, I didn't mean to derail you on the social media part, because that's just a little bit of it. But
yeah.
So I think this is the old Borders bookstore on the corner there, and that's a really nice building. So what do you have to be a member to? I know the libraries are involved in this, right?
Yeah. It's a community technology library, and so the Dew Space on the first floor, you can become a member, and mm-hmm. I encourage everybody, our viewers, to become a member. It's free, and you can get a Dew Space card, and then all of that, all of the resources are available to the greater community free of charge. And then on the second level, we don't really require a membership, but we require registration for particular kinds of learning.
Like a class.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And some of the classes will be free, and then some of the courses will have a nominal fee that would be associated with it. And then in addition to, you know, I mentioned a lot about workforce development, we will have a Pearson View Testing Center on the second level.
What's
also.
That, Pierce?
Pearson View Testing Center. So a lot of those Microsoft certifications or Apple certifications will require you to test.
I got you.
Test in a qualified testing center, and the testing center needs to meet certain kind of criteria. Mm-hmm. So we will have a top of the line testing facility in the Dew Space on the second level also.
This is really a fantastic addition to the menu, because it's unique.
Unique to Omaha.
Yeah, it's unique to Omaha, and it's not being done everywhere, very many places.
No, there are other kind of innovation spaces, learning spaces in the country, but
this is the only one of its kind.
It is very unique. So the concept is new. And then one thing that I really should mention is that our kickoff event.
Yes.
We are providing a Science on a Sphere as our kickoff to what we're doing at the Dew Space. And so
the science. Is this on the second floor now?
It is all on the second floor. Mm-hmm. And the Science on a Sphere is a 6-foot diameter sphere that provides over 500 data sets, learning opportunities that
there's a view
that
of
students
it.
That students can learn about water, atmosphere, space, land, and it really brings together a visualization of, in kind of a fun, entertaining way, a visualization of what is happening globally. So we can look at the tsunami that happened in Japan and look at the impact that it had on the entire world. And instead of just looking at a one-dimensional book kind of, but it brings it all to life.
I mean, do you learn this on your own there, or is it an instruction environment, or what is it?
Yeah, that's a good question. We have folks who are providing demonstrations, and then we also want to be able to have some individual learning that people can take an idea, or if there's a special interest that a student or an adult might have, that if they're interested in Mars and looking at, you know, the biggest crater in the solar system, we can look at Mars and we can zoom in and look at what that looks like. So so far, you know, we're finding, you know, students are coming, you know, little kids like eighth graders are coming to the Dew Space to view the Science on a Sphere, and they're very knowledgeable and so about the continent and all the continents and water and land, and they'll come with specific kinds of questions, and then so we can search up within those 400 to 500 data sets and bring to life some of the questions that they have. The Science on a Sphere is, like I said, it's our kickoff, and then it is sponsored in part by Omaha Public School System, UNO, and Metropolitan Community College. And we'll have, it'll be here just for a couple of weeks and just serve as a kickoff. And then we plan at the Dew Space to offer, you know, a variety of youth all the way through retirement kinds of learning opportunities.
Kind of nonstop, one like an art gallery showing, I mean, in essence?
Yeah. And really, whatever ideas you have or what the greater community has is what we'll offer at the Dew Space. And so we'll have a little bit of a twist on innovation and technology, most definitely, because that's what it's about. It's really kind of like a digital workshop in a lot of ways. But whatever ideas the community has, we have 11 pages of typed notes that community people have given us from focus groups and talking with the community of what they would like. So that's the type of programming that we'll offer.
Do you have some plans down the line for the immediate future you could share?
Well, I think for the most part, the Science on a Sphere with NOAA, with the National Oceanic Atmospheric Association, is our big kickoff at this point. And I think that we down the road, we will want to showcase specific kinds of things, but I envision a high-end like speaker series. I think that the greater Omaha area has all kinds of, we have Fortune 500 companies, we have all kinds of expertise that resides within Omaha, and I would like to be able to use the Dew Space on the second floor, our space, to be able to showcase a lot of that expertise that resides within Omaha and showcase it to the broader scope.
That's great.
And I think that, you know, I would be remiss to mention that there is a digital divide that exists within Omaha, you know, north, south, and there was some research that was done, and the Dew Space, in large part, is a free community technology center that's intended to bridge that gap of digital divide. So we'll focus on technology development and innovation and provide that for people who do not have access, especially to folks who can't afford access to digital technologies, or even people learning in retirement who may not have a computer.
You bet.
You used to be able to get by as a retired person not having a computer, but now You know, we have people who will come in and say, you know, my provider told me I need to log on and I need to do this and I don't know what.
Not so optional anymore.
It isn't optional, yeah. So, anyway, we provide services to those folks who don't have access.
That's great. Very unique outreach to continuing education for Metropolitan Community College. How's the response been to the Do Space so far?
It's been amazing. It's been truly amazing. I think that depending upon the day, I think that the Do Space itself can attract, you know, 400 to 600 to 700 people a day. And then we plan, at least during the time that we have the Science on a Sphere, during our kickoff event, we plan to circulate 10,000 to 15,000 kids through that Science on a Sphere and through the space.
Let's talk about the other aspects of continuing education at Metropolitan Community College, just to give people an idea of the scope of it and the breadth and depth of it. We talked about the number of classes and the number of people reached. One thing I was curious about is how dynamic is the offering menu? I assume it's based upon what the community wants, correct?
That's correct. So I think that right now we're building on a lot of the success that has already resided in continuing ed, and continuing ed has existed at Metropolitan for well over 30 years, or the inception of Metropolitan Community College. And I think that the College for Kids, College for Teens has a very popular, you know, reputation within the greater Omaha area. And we plan to expand those areas, especially now that we have the Do Space. We can provide some College for Kids and Teens kinds of programming that have an innovation kind of, mm-hmm. you know, Lego animation and Lego robotics and that sort of thing. So the College for Kids and College for Teens definitely have had a pretty significant impact on the community. A lot of the folks who have participated in College for Kids and College for Teens have now graduated, and their kids are also you know in those programs. So most definitely the breadth of those programs have a long history and a very good reputation. And once again, in terms of that programming, we pull teachers from the community who teach those courses. And so we once again showcase expertise that resides within the Omaha area. In addition, there are a variety of workforce development kinds of things that we've offered, continuing education units that provide recertification and refreshers for like the insurance professional population. And
if you're in an industry, employed in an industry where your employer thinks it's necessary for you to get more education, you probably already know about the opportunity.
That's
right?
Correct.
For those kinds of, that kind of programming.
Right. And right now, I'm doing an audit to even expand those kinds of offerings, to look at continuing education units and what's needed, you know, for the profession to be able to expand what we do with continuing education units. A lot of professions require, you know, 15 continuing education units to stay current and to keep their licensure, and so we want to still continue to build on that.
Yeah. We've only got about 5 minutes left, and I'm sure there are a lot of things you had in mind you'd like to share. Just go ahead and do that, and we'll clean up with the time remaining.
Okay. Well, I think that what my plan is as a new director of continuing education certainly is to build the Do Space. That's very exciting, and then also expand our travel opportunities and develop like a traveling classroom kind of concept, where I've talked to a lot of folks in the community who love to travel and love to learn and travel, but maybe they don't want to travel by themselves or they have some restrictions like that.
I'm glad you mentioned that, because this brings in the day trips.
Yes.
It's been going on for quite a while.
Right.
But I don't know that everybody knows about them.
Right. No, the day trips, they're in our catalog, and they're hugely successful. And we have one day trip that's a mystery tour, And so you really don't even know where you're going to go until the day you arrive. And so that sells out, you know, immediately, or people sign up for that. And so to build on that kind of concept, and I've gotten lots and lots of ideas from folks to even build on those. And right now, our day trips, that's what they are, they're day trips. We go to Kansas City, or we go to regional kind of places. Mm-hmm. But there's nothing to say that we couldn't extend that into some international kind of learning mm-hmm. opportunities, where somebody could come to a culinary course and learn about French cooking, and then maybe even
go
learn
to Paris.
Yep, even learn maybe some just language, you know, basic French language, and then have our faculty take that group to Paris, yeah. and they can learn the foods, learn the language, and it can culminate into a real rich learning.
So
experience.
One of the focuses you would like to push is the travel part.
Yep.
What else is in the future in your plans?
Workforce development is another one, and then also extend a lot of the learning opportunities that we have to the online world. And so extend some of the expertise that we have that resides at Metropolitan Community College in an online. We still have lots of folks in the professional and in world who maybe they can't come to a face-to-face kind of experience. And so we're developing some real estate licensure and brokerage kinds of continuing ed units that are available, that are going to be available online.
Great
versus
idea.
Having to go, you know, face to face. And so that kind of perspective would not only provide just a local regional kind of market, but also could be a national market. And so transitioning some of those kinds of experiences to online is another goal. And then just also developing innovation. I think that the greater Omaha, there's a lot of innovation that exists, and showcasing innovation that exists within the Omaha area.
At the new space. Primarily.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right.
So go to the website. Or if you want a catalog, you can call the college for that.
Yep.
I mean, that's the best way to kind of get a feel for what's being offered, right?
That's exactly right.
And then just a minute on how to register. You can register online, you can register by phone,
yep.
register in
or
person.
Call our office. Yep. You can call our office, or you can register by phone or call our contact center and then register.
What's the cost factor for continuing education classes?
That is an interesting question. Really, like I said, there are some things that are free, and especially at the due space, and then there are some things that are $10 to $15. And then when we get into some of the like professional certifications, like Microsoft Office or an Apple certification, those kind of certifications could be multiple hundreds of dollars, especially if you have to certify in a you have to certify and take a test, then there's a charge that you pay for that. So I would say, $10 or $15 all the way up to multiple hundreds of dollars.
Yeah.
But the price point really is, we make it very inexpensive. And when you look at a lot of opportunities, especially travel opportunities, we make them very, very, very affordable.
One quick question back to the due space to close. Do you need a card to get in, or what do you do?
Yeah, you can get a due space card. You can, right when you come into the door of the due space, you can get a due space card.
Okay, you can get it there.
Yep, you can get it there. And you can, it's free.
Very good.
And it takes about 3 minutes to get a card.
We'll have to do this again. Thanks, Gary. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Very much. Gary Girard, Director of Continuing Education at the college. And thanks for being with us again on Metro and More. Our goal is to better acquaint you with the mission, reach, and the leadership of the college. I'm Kent Pavelka for Metropolitan Community College. If you have comments or questions about the program, please email us at metrovision@mccneb.edu. Thanks for watching.
This has been a Metrovision production produced by Metropolitan Community College.